Jared from TaBota Fitness. Welcome to my own home gym since we're quarantined. Can't go into TaBota. But I'm still going to be bringing you workouts from right here. So first, I show you around the place a little bit. First of all, the workout you're going to be doing today, right up here on the board. We're going to be doing a little bit of a mobility work first before going into a brutal TaBota here on a Tuesday. 20 on, 10 off, 8 rounds. We're going to be doing push-ups, rows, some jump ropes, some side planks, some squats, some more planking. So we'll get two different kinds of planks in. But first we're going to get all that mobility work in here. And then my kind of workout area, I have my squat rack. This is kind of the main place of exercise for me, at least at the moment. Deadlift platform right there. My little grappling dummy guy, so I can train jujitsu even during quarantine. Trap bar for some deadlifts. Got fast feet box, a medicine ball, one stability ball there. My TRX bands, one of my favorite tools right there. Some kettlebells, bands, dumbbells over there. This is my pain cave area right here. I've got my bike, I've got my boxing bag, I've got my treadmill, some Texas Longhorns, Hook'em Horns, and of course Rocky looking over me, and a little heating and cooling going on. Don't worry, I'm not freezing in here. And the music, I got my iPad hooked up. I have a little TaBota timer on there. Hopefully this works well today. We'll see. If not, just follow along with me for the workout, but I have a feeling that we'll be just fine. And some speakers I got going right there. So, get us all situated. So, what we're gonna need for the actual workout, just our bodies and maybe a band put around some things, or a chair to hold onto, or I have my bench right here. Hopefully I need the screen, check that out a little bit. First we're gonna start with a regular warm-up, jogging in place here. After we get our nice and warm, we're going to some mobility, and as I said in a video that I think Tanya posted on our Instagram page the other day, also follow us on Instagram, TaBota Fitness, Jared Green 3, and Bo and Tanya. Awesome stuff. We're still giving you information on there as well as on these live videos that we are working out with you during. So, after jogging place, going to some nice, easy jumping jacks, working that mobility of the shoulders here. Get those hips involved. Remember, we can go into that jumping version if you want your heart rate going. And into some high knees. I like to grab that knee, get a good stretch from right up to my toe. Priming my body a little bit. First part of our workout today, as I said, it's gonna be a lot of mobility. What's awesome about this? Oh, that's what I was saying earlier. I said it in one of those Instagram videos. Is that during this whole quarantine thing, we do some tap backs here. During this whole quarantine thing, obviously we have a lot of time for ourselves right now. And in order to make the best out of a bad situation, I think mobility is something we could all focus on. And during some of these moves that we go through today, it's basically going to take us through an entire body mobility circuit. Pick a few that you really like or that you think bring you value. Do them repeatedly throughout the day. I'd say 2 to 5 times, a couple rounds of the ones that you really like. So maybe pick 2 or 3 of them and hammer out those areas that you feel you're weak on. When we get back into the gym, and you get back in your regular life, you will notice differences in improving your mobility. After that mobility, that's where we're going to pick up the intensity though. Don't worry, we're still coming at you with a pretty intense TaBota today, or TaBota. Right? So now I'm going into side lunges. Side to side. Nice wide base here, gripping the floor, spreading it apart. Make sure my knee goes over my toe, and I keep that tall torso. some crossover. Make sure
my screen is good here. Oh, my head was probably cut off during that whole thing, huh? All right, that should be good.
So, mobility, starting off, we're gonna do each of these for about 20, 30 seconds. First one, we're starting right up top of the neck, doing some neck circles. So I'm gonna take my palms, I'm gonna face them toward you guys, so you guys are facing toward me. Set those shoulders, staying as tall as I can, so I'm gonna take some space between the hips and the ribs. I'm gonna tuck my tailbone a little bit. From here, I'm gonna look up to the ceiling and then draw my chin down. As I do that, I'm gonna imagine there's a string on top of my head, pulling me back. I'm kind of making that double chin here. Then from there, going to my shoulder with my chin, letting my ear fall to my shoulder. And then I'm going to take a big circle going up and around. Slow. And if you feel any pain during these mobility exercises, super slow, you should be going with me. Keep those shoulders set. Keep that tailbone tucked. If you feel any pain, stop. Don't move through pain ever, whether it's during mobility, any other regular exercise. Pain is an indicator that something is wrong. From here, I'm gonna tuck my chin to the other shoulder. Come back to the middle. Look back up. And draw back down. Remember, thing is standing upright and tucking in. Shoulders set, core brace, glutes on. Bring my chin to that other shoulder now, go the opposite way. Let that ear fall. Really want to keep our mouth shut. Tongue glued to the roof of the mouth as we draw this big circle. While we're on the neck, we're gonna get the levator's calf here. So when our shoulders are set, we can stretch that trap. But if I take my hand up, put it right on that trap muscle as best as I can, drive my elbow out, I can then tuck my chin, grab onto my head and lightly pull toward that other armpit as I just look down. Almost think of like trying to sniff my armpit. You'll feel this stretch going through what's called the levator scap. A lot of times, I know personally, this is super tight on me. And if I get injured lifting, exercising, moving around, it's usually through this muscle here. Other side. Really quick. As we're stretching, remember, keep that space. Big breaths into the belly through the nose. And as we exhale, sitting deeper into the stretch. All right, now we're gonna do what's called an air rifle flip. And take one hand, bring it into our chest, set. Other arm's gonna come out, go thumbs up, and rotate that thumb as far as you can. Notice I'm not letting my shoulder kind of internally rotate a little bit. Now I'm gonna take my thumb and reach it toward my back. While keeping my shoulder pulled away from my ear, that chin tuck and my shoulder set. And then come back up. Go thumbs up. Bring it in. And switch sides. Trying to stay square, tucked, and set. Draw that thumb back. Staying tall, coming up, Around. Now we're gonna do one more on each side. Really rotate, reach. Keep that chin tucked. Now as I draw back, I'm gonna pull that shoulder down away from the ear. Then lift it up. Come around. Those shoulders. Now we're going to go to what's called a standing windmill stretch. I'm going to turn that music just a touch. A standing windmill stretch. So for this, we're going to get into a little bit of a staggered stance. Whichever leg that goes back, that arm is going to extend up toward the ceiling. I'm going to make sure I keep those ribs hidden and my tailbone tucked, reaching for the floor. So I have good brace here. I'm reaching, my other arm is going right on the inside of my thigh, pointing toward my toes. Now from here, I'm gonna hinge back. And as I hinge back, I'm gonna look up toward that top hand. Chest stays tall, back stays straight. I'm gonna rotate through. Notice how I'm not reaching and falling, I'm staying tall, and my hips go back. Slight bend in my front leg. Shoulders set tight, hand reaching for the sky. I trace all the way down to my fingertips, touch the ground. If you can't get this far, that's perfectly fine. If you're up here, this is as far as you get, that's where you are right now. You can continue to improve this rotation through the thoracic spine and that hinge to get yourself down. Then drive up. We're gonna do two more on this side, all right? Staggered stance, arm elevated, ribs tucked, butt tucked, reach and rotate. Stay tall, don't let that chest cave. Stay tall, long spine, reaching back with your butt. Imagine like you're shutting that car door with your butt. Reaching back, stay tall with that chest, looking up toward that hand, and push out. One more. Tracing out a little bit faster this time, stay tall, hold at the bottom. 3, 2, 1 and up, switching sides. Switching those feet that I have staggered, reaching up with the arm of the foot that's back. Up, set, brace, hinging. Keeping that shoulder set, keeping a straight line between both arms. As I look up, keep that chest tall and my obliques active here as I rotate and drive. Two more. Stay tall, breathe, brace, and stand. Last one. And up. Next, going into a hip exercise we call airplanes. Grabbing onto something is great for this. So I'm going to hold on. I'm going to hinge back. So same idea. I'm pushing that butt backwards, not reaching forward. Reaching forward with my shoulders. Hinging, holding. I'm gonna push through my leg, keeping my knee out over my toes and my glutes active in order to open my legs as far as I can. So I'm pushing through my hip to open the other hip. Notice I still have a soft bend, I'm not locked out here. Good, that could hurt you. Soft bend, but not pushing that knee forward. Driving through my heel and my hip to open. Staying tall, reaching with that back leg. And then I'm going to drop it all the way down. Breathe. Now I'm trying to get my back hip lower than my front hip here. One more time. Up. Drop it. And stand. Switching legs here. Hinging back. Reaching. Bracing. Driving up through. Notice I'm opening, fall over while I'm trying to talk. Hinging, I'm leaning on this for support. I'm opening, I'm trying to get this knee to stay active. I'm not just letting it cave in. I'm pushing out, keeping that inside ankle high on this down leg, and opening through my hips. And then I'm dropping. And then I'm opening. If this is difficult for you, a smaller hinge, makes this move a whole lot easier. I like this one a lot, so I get to a pretty deep pinch. If you want to elevate it up, for future reference here, try to do it with nothing to balance on. Using those arms as a guide. I'm not just flinging over my chest. I'm moving from my hips here. All right, so I pinch, like come to a 45, push through, keep that big toe gripping the ground, and then drop. Push through, and then drop. So that's what it would look like if you didn't use that support. I really like using the support to open up those hips. Very similar to that 90-90 position I love so much, but this is elevated, and you can really get that stabilization going through that glute med there. From there, we're gonna take a kneeling position. Go into that combat base. My back leg is gonna be tucked, right? So I'm not straight forward, I'm tucking this leg a little bit. Then from here, tall, stretching through this hip flexor at the top. Then I'm gonna drive that knee forward over my front leg. Letting myself open up through the hips, knee driving out, I'm improving my ankle mobility on the bottom. I'm squeezing the floor with my feet, gripping with my toes. And then I'm gonna lift my toes up, hold, squeeze through that shin, grip again, drive out. We're gonna go through this two more times. Hinge or lean forward, knee out over the toes, gripping the floor, play with your hip there a little bit, and then push that knee out in line with your second toe. Lift those toes up off the ground, activate that shin, grip, and drive one more. Stretch to the hip flexor, the back by tucking those hips, getting this good stretch, standing tall, relax that, and lean forward. Get that knee as far over the ankle as you can while keeping it active. You don't want to let the ankle fold. See how I'm at this awful angle? I want to stay out, active, and press up. Switching sides, dropping the other leg, opening, tucking, hinging up, extending up, squeezing my butt cheek, getting that good stretch. Relax, stretch forward, knee out, and stand. Relax, knee forward, gripping that ground, squeeze it, knee out over that second toe. Now lift those toes up, feel that front of the shin, feel your toes active. A lot of people lose kind of connection to their toes. Getting that back, it's a great thing to try to do during quarantine. Start picking things up with your feet. No one can judge you except the people in your house. Don't drive them crazy, but you know what I mean. Drive up out of there one more time. Forward, knee way out over that toe, stretching through that ankle. This is huge for squats. A lot of times what people lose in squats is either hip mobility or ankle mobility. If my ankles don't move forward when I'm squatting, this is about as low as I get. And then I have to start tipping forward. But my knees are allowed to move forward just a touch, right? And it depends on when you move. The cue of not letting your knees go past your toes is more so because a lot of people will squat like this, which is awful for the knees. But if I start with my hips, in order to get a sufficient depth, my knees must travel forward. So if you lack that ankle mobility, you won't be able to get good depth in your squat while remaining upright. All right. Quadruped, wrist, before going on to cat and cow, and then we have our TaBota. So, on all fours, squeeze the ground, set those shoulders, we're gonna come out over the hands, and rock back. Over the hands. Now with this, putting as much or as little pressure on your wrists as feels comfortable for you. You can even do this exercise with your hands. You don't even have to drop down to all fours in that quadruped position. So I'm here, shoulders are set. I'm kind of thinking of screwing my hand into the ground, but it's not moving. My fingers stay facing forward. I set those shoulders, get the pits of my elbows facing forward, and then I rock as far forward as I feel comfortable. Forwards and backwards. Now I'm gonna get into a comfortable position. I'm gonna play with lifting my fingers up off the ground while keeping my arms straight. And gripping the ground with them, coming forward and backwards. Lift them again. Now we're gonna take our hands and we're gonna turn them around. This might feel very sensitive for some of you. Definitely come up here with that thumb right in the joint, create a little traction to stretch yourself. I'm going down to the ground, putting the back of my hands on the ground, setting those shoulders, and then coming back as far as I can while maintaining my shoulders set and my arms straight. Coming forward so I straighten my wrist and then rock back. And then from one of those middle positions, I'm gonna make a fist on the ground. This is gonna be incredibly difficult. You'll feel cramping going on in your forearms like crazy. It's okay. Relax. All right, last one. Going through some cat and cow. Quadruped still. Shoulders over the wrists, knees right under the hips. Neutral position with my spine. Chin tucked, shoulders back. And I'm gonna drop my belly button to the floor by arching through my hips and pulling my shoulders back. Take a big breath. Exhale, tip those hips under. So I'm pulling my hips under, thinking about getting my ribs and hips closer together and hiding my belly button as I draw in and round my back as much as I can, tucking the chin, pushing through the hands, letting my shoulder blades round forward, my hips roll under, big breath in, and exhale, back out. Looking up, drawing those shoulders back, dropping your belly button as low as it goes to the ground. And again, big inhale in, exhale as you punch up, big breath in, round up as far as you can, and rest. All right, let me make sure video is still good.
All right, we're doing great. Pretty sure. All right, so
going into our TaBota. Our first exercise is going to be a push-up in a row. Remember with the push-ups, we can do them against the wall. We can do them elevated on a chair or a bench. We can do them on our knees. Or we can do them up on our toes. To make it harder, you can go from your toes and add a shoulder tap and at the top. In between our push-up rounds, you're gonna grab a partner, a chair, or a band, right? So grab a band if you have them. And we're gonna do some rows. If you have dumbbells, you can row with those, keeping that chest tall, shoulders set, elbows pulling to the side. The important thing with rows is I keep my back straight. I don't let my shoulder round forward. I keep that back, and I pull that elbow to the side by using those big muscles of my back. Keeping that shoulder set is going to be what allows me to do that. If I have a band, I'm doing rows, moving around something, setting and pulling. If I have nothing to loop it around, I'm just gonna take my band and do band pulls. And if I don't have a band or anything to loop it around, I'm gonna do a field goal squeeze, or what I like to call a posture squeeze. In this, I'm gonna get tall, glute squeeze, ribs tight, or abs tight, tuck that chin, push the back of my hand to the wall as I draw my elbows down my ribs. Now from here, I feel all the muscles of my back engaging, and I'll hold that for 20 seconds, okay? So, push-ups for the first 20 seconds, 10 second rest, going into rows,
get a drink.
So this is gonna be pretty tough. Push-ups and rows, 8 rounds. So 4 of each, alternating back and forth. I'm gonna go with the standard version of each. Toe push-ups, rows on the my bar here. If I have a partner, they can hold on, right? Or I could wrap it around something, or I could just do those posture holds. Those are excellent. Actually, I'll probably alternate back and forth between doing actual rows and that posture hold. Remember, modify push-ups whichever way you have to get a full range of motion without those shoulders coming forward. Keeping set, keeping braced, pulling, and pushing. Starting with push-ups, 20 on, 10 off. We have 8 rounds of these two. Push-ups, 20 seconds. Notice how I'm not going out of control, keeping those hands squeezed in the ground, keeping those shoulders set, pulling myself all the way down, and going all the way up. We have 3 seconds, 2, 1, and a 10-second rest. Going into my rows here. Shoulders tight, chest up tall, pulling those elbows to my side. The farther I walk back, the more resistance I get. And resting. Back to push-ups. 3, 2, 1, we're going. Resting, good work. Going into rows.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, we're doing posture holds this time. Setting, staying tall, drawing back, pushing.
Halfway there.
It's as hard as you make them, and I'm sweating. 2, 1. Back into push-ups in 3, 2, 1. We're gone. I'm gonna go back to those rows.
3, 2, 1, go. Halfway there.
Last push-up coming up. We got this.
3, 2, 1.
Set, brace, pull. Drive those hands away. Keep those shoulders set. Keep those hands gripping the ground. Your fingertips should be white here. One more set of rows. Once again, I'm going those posture holds here, making it tough.
3, 1, go.
Staying tall, chin tucked back. Bracing. Talking isn't too easy.
Halfway there.
Power breathing behind the shield.
3, 2, 1.
And rest. A It's a wrap for our first two exercises. Now, going into some jump ropes. If you don't have a jump rope, I'm sorry, I should have mentioned this earlier. I'll give you a couple minutes to go grab a jump rope if you do have one. If you don't have one, no big deal. We're gonna do mock jump ropes. If mock jump ropes bother you, you shouldn't be jumping. If you have any pre-existing knee condition, if you are recovering from an ankle injury, do not be jumping up and down a whole lot, right? Do what you can to improve from there. You can go into some high knees. You can do some sprint in place. You can do some forward and backward steps if you'd like. I am going with a regular jump rope. I bet you I'll try to get overconfident, try to throw in some double unders and mess up miserably, which will give you all a good laugh at home. Remember, if you are jump roping at home, elbows to the side, hands slightly out in front, tension to the core, sending that energy through your legs, right up into your hands. Let's get ready to go. 8 rounds of this. Difficulties. Alright, we'll be good. I just gotta do the timer on my clock instead of on the app. So we're gonna be going here in 10 seconds. In 4, 3, 2, 1, doing some jump ropes. Cool. So let me get caught. See? What's going on? See, I'm bad foul here. There we go. 10 seconds in. There we go. And rest. 10 second rest. That was not very good for me. I ran into just about everything I could with my jump rope. And we're going. Get started. 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Frustrated here, 5 seconds. I might be on a screen here, and go. Ten more seconds. 3, 2, 1, and rest. 10 second rest. Don't worry. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're resting. 10-second rest. In 3, 2, 1, go.
Shoulder set, bracing hard. 5 seconds. Two,
was switching sides. In 5 seconds, 2, 1, go. Stay tall, pushing those hips up. 5 more seconds, 3, 2, 1, and rest. 3 more on that side. You have 5 seconds, 2, 1, go. Grace Anthony, grip, lats, abs, and glutes here. 10 more seconds.
Alternating back and forth. After this, you just have one round left.
squats and iso squat holds coming at you in 10 seconds. Like I said, I'm starting with the chair version. You can start with any of the ones I show, weighted squats, not weighted squats, jumping, tuck jumps in 2, 1, we're going. Staying upright, maintain that space between your ribs and hips, stay braced, squeeze those glutes at the top, but don't over arch, right? Stay tall at the top. In 2, 1, resting. 10 seconds, our next move is that iso squat. So we're gonna be holding the squat in the bottom position for 20 here in 2, 1, go. Keep that space and brace. Chin's tucked, chest up, see what's in front of you. We have 5 more seconds. 2, 1, and we're standing, shaking it out. 2 rounds down, 6 to go. 5 seconds. I'm going to regular squats now in 2, 1, go. If you're having knee cobbles, changing the depth, grabbing something like I showed earlier, sitting in something, or just take the time to go slow through a couple of squats. You don't have to go super fast if you don't have the technique and rest. 10 seconds, then we're doing that iso hold again. If you have the technique, trying to get in a lot while keeping it in 2, 1, go, hold. Good depth. 10 more seconds. Remember, don't progress with me if you don't feel comfortable. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Three seconds, 2, 1, iso holds again. Remember, you can hold on to something, you can sit and hover, bracing, squeezing, feet gripping the ground, knees out, stay tall, 10 more seconds, don't just relax, 4, 3, 2, 1, and standing, good work. I'm going with those tuck jumps to end my regular squats, coming up in 3, 2, 1, we're going. Iso squat holds, especially because I just lifted before this, and go. Iso squat holds. I did some squats with the barbell, so my legs are definitely feeling this. We've got 10 seconds left. I can make it, and you can too. 4, 3, 2, 1, standing, shaking it out, resting. Last exercise. We've got a plank. Now, I chose this one for last. Because a lot of people think planks are easy. I'm here to tell you, if you think a plank is easy, you've never planked with me. When we're planking, whether you're on your knees or on your toes, whether you're on your hands or your elbows, whether you're elevated, wherever you are, what I said here, your grip, lats, pulling those shoulders down, abs, super tight, glutes, super tight, right? I don't want glutes. When we go to the Idea Fit conference, right, I take a bunch of TRX classes, One of their favorite things is make apples, not applesauce. So think that when you're playing game, apples in the front and in the back, shoulder set, bracing everything as tight as you can for 8 rounds, 20 on, 10 off, then we're done. That's a workout. All right, we're going in 10. Planking. Whatever you feel comfortable, elevated, knees, elbows, hands, whatever you feel best with, go. Shoulders pulled back, chin tucked, glute squeeze tight, and it gets harder to talk after about 10 seconds. We're halfway there. Squeeze everything, driving those elbows toward your toes, toes toward your elbows, and rest. It's another huge part. If I think of driving back from my toes and my elbows, imagine it's the heaviest object in the world is about to squish everyone you love. And you want to hold it in there super tight. And go. Kind of missed that by 2 seconds, so we're going to go 2 seconds over. Brace. Squeeze, apples, not applesauce, right? Brace it tight. 3, 2, 1. Rest it in. 2 down, 6 to go. We got this. 3, 2, 1. And go. Got 5 seconds, get set. 2, 1, go. Stay tight. Stay with me. Bracing everything as tight as you can. Shaking. And 2, 1. We are done. All right. Thank you for joining me. Thank you all for joining these workouts. They've been awesome. Personally, I know I'm super blessed to have this space here to work out. The fact that you guys are working out at home with us is just shows how committed you are to your fitness, how much you like us as your trainers, which is awesome as well. And as you're stretching, I just want to give you kind of that thought in your head that we appreciate everything that you guys are doing, and I hope that you appreciate us. And just to be grateful for what we do have during these times. I know I keep saying it over and over again, but I've seen a lot of really good stuff and some positivity come out of this quarantine that I didn't quite expect. So thank you. Thanks to everyone out there that I see that from. See you again. Good workout.